You got Boku,
Boku
business ideas. You got Boku business ideas. You got Boku,
Boku
business ideas. You got Boku business ideas. You got Boku business ideas. You got Boku business ideas.
Hi, I'm Guy Nelson. Welcome to my video on how to create ideas for your new business. I started my own business as a trainer for creativity in the workplace. It comes from years, decades of experience as an improv theater performer and teacher here in Seattle and all over the world. I love helping people expand their minds and find creativity and innovative solutions to problems, new ideas for products and services in their companies and in their organizations. I'm glad you're here because today I'm going to share with you some of the biggest, most useful ways to come up with really cool ideas. Ideas that make people's lives better or easier. Ideas you can turn into products and services that will make you a successful inventor and entrepreneur. Are you ready? Let's go! Okay, here's the first and most important thing. Creativity, the ability to come up with new ideas, is a skill. Yes, it's a skill that you can learn, and you can learn to be really good at it. You do this by optimizing two things, your attitude and your behavior. Let's start with the first step. Optimize your attitude. You have to believe that you can create great ideas. Here's one of my favorite quotes from George Bernard Shaw. Some men see things as they are and ask why. Others dream things that never were and ask why not. That should be the motto of every entrepreneur, especially you. Be the one who always asks, why not? I'm convinced nearly everyone has a million-dollar idea. My favorite example of that is something that changed the entire world of travel almost overnight. Wheeled luggage. It could have been you sitting there in the airport watching people lug these giant heavy suitcases around. I remember those days. And then someone, somewhere, thought, why not put wheels on the luggage? And it happened. And now everyone, everywhere, wheels their luggage around. Hooray! Now, it didn't take a rocket scientist to come up with that idea. Just someone who was observant and imaginative. Two skills that we're going to highlight in this video. So, start with your mind. You're much more likely to be creative if you tell yourself you are creative. Every day. Yes, I can do it. I can be it. I can make it happen. I am a creative thinker. Of course, other people will tell you no. That can't happen because we don't have enough time, we don't have enough money, we don't have enough people. Whatever. Ignore them, at least for now. Channel your energy into positive thoughts. Instead, surround yourself with the yes people in the world, people who can imagine great things and who have fun exploring ideas, and not those who will always find reasons why something can't happen. If they roll their eyes and shake their head at you and ask you, how are you going to do that? Just say, I don't know yet, but I'm going to figure it out. The next step, optimize your behavior. There are five key ways to change your behavior to get clear, positive results. Number one, use yourself. Number two, observe others. Number three, listen. Number four, be curious. And number five, imagine. First of all, use yourself. You're a person with lots of life experiences and opinions. These are great resources that you can turn into ideas for great products or services. You probably have passions, things that you're really excited about, like making great chocolate chip cookies, or gardening, or sewing, or pet grooming. I know a woman in Seattle who's a balloon designer. She blows up balloons to decorate at events and conferences. How did she get started? Well, she always loved decorating for her kids' birthday parties, so she went online and learned some tricks to do it on a big scale, and it totally took off. and she turned her passion of loving to decorate with balloons into a very successful business. So consider this. How can I share my passion with the world? Make a list of the things you love doing and note how others could benefit from your expertise. Nowadays, it's easy to go online and find the right audience for your business idea. They'll like you, they'll follow you, and you can connect with other sites that will promote your work. Step number two, observe others. Like the person in the airport watching people struggle with their heavy luggage, pay attention to what other people are doing and how they use things. What frustrates them? It might be a task that they hate and would gladly pay others like you to do for them. And that could be your business idea. Hooray! Look for gaps and problems in existing areas. Notice trends in areas like health, hobbies, education, local foods, and recreation. Think about the intersection between what you love, what the world needs, and what people will pay for. Number three, listen to everything going on around you. Do you hear people complaining about something? What bugs them, and what can you do about it? Look around you in your community. What problems are there that people are constantly talking about? Make a list of possible solutions, no matter how crazy, and think, could I possibly turn that into a business? Then, listen for feedback. When you get a cool business idea, share it with people who might actually use it. Take their suggestions and go back and make some changes. And push the idea of failure out of your mind. I believe that the only people who really fail are the ones who never try. Number four, be curious. Turn yourself into a question machine. Talk to customers, talk to shoppers. Ask them what they would like to see in the marketplace that isn't already there. What size, what color, what shape, and what price. Maybe the biggest key to becoming a successful entrepreneur is to understand human needs. And we have a lot of them. The need to fit in, the need to save money, to look and feel important, to prioritize our kids and our pets, to feel cared for, and to eat and live comfortably. What are some simple things you can think of to help people meet some of these most basic human needs? And finally, number five, imagine. Let your mind wander. Unplug from your daily grind. Spend some time in quiet contemplation so your mind can expand and take flight. Think about new trends on the horizon, maybe some new technologies, and imagine moving in that direction. Ask yourself the question, what if? Imagine, what if X existed? What if people could do X? You might have a keen sense of improvement. You might look at something that already exists and think, yeah, I could do that better, or I could do it cheaper. There could be a new use for something that already exists, a way to reuse it or recycle it, or link things together and make an entirely new product or service out of it. So that's it, my friend. Some surefire ways to help you develop some new business ideas. And remember, these are skills. The more you use them, the better you'll get at it, and the faster you'll get at it. So, let's review. Here are the key steps you can take right now. Optimize your attitude. Believe you can do it and be it. And optimize your behavior. Use yourself. Observe others. Listen to everything around you. Be curious and imagine. And one more thing. Carry a notebook around with you and write down everything interesting that you observe and can think of. Before long, it'll be filled, and your next great business idea will be ready to emerge. So, thanks for watching, and good luck.
You got Boku, Boku business ideas. You got Boku business ideas. You got Boku, Boku business ideas. You got Boku business ideas. You got Boku business ideas. You got Boku business ideas.